I gotta get a better filler nozzle for this gas can. These California gas filler nozzles are really irritating. I like that, it starts nice. I haven't ran it in a few weeks. Oh, a couple weeks anyway. Walk around, make sure my blade's tight. Got plenty of water. It's almost 70 degrees out here. And yes, I'm wearing a sweatshirt, but I'm used to it being hot. It's kind of chilly here, so may come off later. We'll see. Howdy, guys. Welcome. I haven't posted in a while. I've been doing some things. It's hard to film and get work done. We'll just say that. So, but I cut this tree down in my grandma's yard and carved her something. We'll go over and check that out later. But it had some really crazy color in it. I think it's a western red cedar. I'm not sure, but you can kind of see all the crazy red and all this crazy brown kind of happening. I want to open it up and see what's in there. Make some end tables and stuff like that next year when it's all dry. So let's cut into it and see what we got. Under that bark. Wow, look at that. That is something pretty. It up here. It's a little thinner, but that color is a lot darker and more defined. Really pretty.
pretty basic down here. Up on the top, it's nice and red though. You can see it starting right here.
Yeah.
This is for those of you who like a little water on it. Pretty awesome grain figure in there.
That black area in the pit there is kind of got some soft spots in it. I'm guessing the same with that. I cut it right down the center of the pith on that one. All right, we got those slabs in the truck over here, cutting that. Now we're gonna go over to my grandma's house where I carved that bear yesterday and got the tree from, bring a sign. I'm gonna carve a sign out of one of these pieces of redwood here. It's the redwood slabs I cut the other day. Cut that side with my chainsaw, and then cut the log in half, and then these are the pieces that I took off to clean up the edge before I got a slab out of it for a different table I'm doing. A couple of them. Might take it out of this back one, it's a little thinner. All right, folks, we're at my grandma's house. Got that sign and that bear put it on there.
Hello, Mr. Daniel.
Hello, Mrs. Grandma. You're on camera, so just so that you know. There's my cool grandma who had that awesome tree. Hey, look at the grain in this bear. No wonder I wanted to put that tree on my sawmill. Grandma, I'll show you some of those boards I cut out of my sawmill in a sec. I got your sign here. Put the sign in his little flanges, and there you go.
How sweet.
Nice and cute, nice and cool.
A lot of people have been slowing down and looking. It's very unique.
It's unique, huh?
I mean, the multicolor. Most of them are just one color, but I think that's gorgeous.
Mm-hmm.
For a bear.
Yeah. He has leprosy or something.
Yeah, well, no, he went to get his hair, hairdo colored.
Yeah.
Is this the boards that were from the tree?
Yeah. I guess you can't see it that well. You can probably see it best from where you're at.
Beautiful. Isn't that beautiful, Dan?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, cool. I was telling Clifford Nimitz yesterday at lunch, he's cutting the tree up and doing that. He says, how long did that take? I said, well, when he actually did the cutting of the bear, I see mine's around an hour. And, yeah. You know, it didn't take very long to do the tree.
About an hour, 45 minutes, an hour, yeah.
That is so cute.
Cool, guys. All right, guys, well, that was fun talking to my grandma. But I gotta go carve a bunch more stuff, so I'm gonna end the day there, and I'll see you next time.